Thank you very much, Dana, and thanks everyone for being here tonight. There are a lot of MFFLs here at American Airlines Center and watching at home on Fox Sports Southwest that have been with us since the NBA awarded an expansion franchise its 23rd franchise to Dallas in 1980. Now, fortunately, we had the right people to guide us in the early days, and some of those members are here tonight. The quartet of Don Carter, Norm Sonju, Rick Sund, and Dick Motta all had a hand as architects of a build that quickly earned the reputation as the model franchise. They brought on board players like Brad Davis and Rolando Blackman, whose numbers hang in the rafters, and they established a base. Brad and Roe established the base, and as others were added and experience gained, the Mavs quickly became a perennial playoff participant. And as someone who experienced all of it, from Moody Madness in 1984 to the captivating run, Game 7 of the 1988 Western Conference Finals, that's who we're honoring tonight, Derek Harper. The Mavericks drafted Derek, number 11, out of Illinois in 1983. Not only was he a key player, but one of the many who bonded with the reunion rowdies that sang Shout and sold out 17,007 strong every night to create one of the great atmospheres of 1980s NBA basketball. One of three players to spend 12-plus seasons with the Mavericks, Derek Harper still holds the top spot in Mavericks history in career assists and steals. He's third in games played and fourth in total points. In addition to his time in Dallas, he played in the NBA Finals in 1994 with the New York Knicks, who are here tonight. At the time of his retirement in 1999, Derek was in the top 12 in NBA history in assists, steals, games played, and three-pointers. And I'm proud to say that he and I have sat next to each other for the last eight seasons, bringing all of you MFFLs here tonight and watching at home the excitement of Mavericks basketball on Fox Sports Southwest. Tonight, everyone, Derek will take a visible and permanent place in the history and legacy of the Mavs with the retirement of number 12.
The Dallas Mavericks select Derek Harper, University of Illinois.
You know, they look forward to the last couple of seconds when you get in that situation where you can win the game or you can make the pass or make the play to win a game. You definitely want to be in that situation.
Retired and put in the Raptors is a well-deserved honor for a good man, a good brother, and a great teammate.
Harp, congratulations. Well-deserved. Long time coming. I'm happy I'm going to be here to see it and see your number go up to the Raptors.
Hey, Harp, congratulations, man. This is a fantastic time for you, such a fantastic career you've had. That intensity, that fantastic purpose that you played with gave us all thrill to being able to be your teammate. So take good care. I'll see you soon.
Derek, from Reunion Arena to American Airlines Arena, congratulations on this well-deserved honor, and it's great to see number 12 for Derek Harper go up in the arena. Congratulations, my friend, and ultimate teammate. Thank you.
Derek, congratulations on having your number retired with the Dallas Mavericks. Well-deserved, and it will look very nice up there in the rafters here at the American Airlines Center.
Hey, Derek, congratulations on having your number retired. We had a lot of battles against other people. I had a lot of battles with you. I think this night is well-deserved. I'm very proud of you. Very honored to call you a friend. Congratulations.
On behalf of Mr. and Mrs. C and the entire Carter family, we are so proud of you. You richly deserve this honor. Mr. C, let me tell you that, Harp, you are the heart of the team, always 100% Maverick on and off the court. Our family will look up with pride at your number 12 jersey hanging over the Maverick court. Friends forever, Don Carter.
We've got a few speakers lined up tonight, everyone, before we hear from Harp himself. First of all, Derek Harper's first NBA coach, the first coach of the Dallas Mavericks. He spent 9 of his 25 seasons as an NBA head coach. It is a thrill to welcome back to Dallas, 9 seasons as a Mavs head coach. Here he is. He came all the way from Idaho, Dick Motta.
When I got the call that they were going to retire Derek's number and ask if I would be in attendance, I would have crawled here. In life, there are some moments that are so cherishable. And how fortunate a kid from Union, Utah could coach in the NBA. Not only coach in the NBA, but to have people like Derek. And while I'm pointing over this way, I've got to say to Ro and to Brad, you know, I wish you people could be half as fortunate as me and have the love that is transponds between us. Derek Harper is a man among men. He was loyal. He was on time. I don't think I ever fined Derek any money. I don't think that I ever raised my voice to Derek. I did to the officials once in a while, but to these three guys here, and Derek won't mind me spreading a little of it to them, I had the best three-guard rotation, I think, in the history of basketball. And I consider it one of the greatest privileges to call Derek the man a friend. And I love Derek Harper.
A teammate of Derek's for 9 seasons with the Mavericks and a season with the New York Knicks. He was a 4-time All-Star. For a lot of years, I was fortunate at events to introduce him as the all-time leading scorer in Mavericks history. Now I get to introduce him tonight as the number 2 scorer in Mavericks history, the wearer of the retired number 22, a great friend, Rolando Blackman.
Thank all of you so very much. It's a fantastic time to be here in honor of a great basketball player like Derek Harper. Let me tell you something. The most important thing when you talk about a point guard and you talk about somebody who is leading a basketball team, you have to know and understand all the personalities that he had to put up with. including our coach, including me, including Mark, including everybody on the team. But he was always ready to lead, always ready to put himself in line to being able to put all the actions that were necessary to being able to have our team come out on top. He was always very consistent. I could always remember. Every time I'd get on the basketball court, I could always remember that intensity, that focused scowl that he had on his face. It looked like you were getting ready with a Doberman pincher out there each and every time you had Derek on the basketball court. But you have to understand and know that the consistency that he had each and every game to understand what the game plan was, manage all of our personalities, and come with the talent. You should have seen him continue to grow and grow and grow each and every year. He was one of the very best point guards to play in the league. Not only could he play offense, but he could D you up tremendously when he got on the court. Our best defensive player on our Maverick team throughout our days. And it was a hardship for me to have to go up against him during our practices. Believe me, that's exactly why it was so easy during the basketball games, because I had to play against him. Derek, I want to tell you, congratulations. You're a fantastic player, a great teammate, and somebody that helped me tremendously with all throughout. I appreciate all of you. Please give a hand to Derek Harper, too. He made us our leader, Derek Harper.
Before we hear from Harp, one more speaker, a teammate of Derek's also for 9 seasons. He's second in Mavs history in games played, and I can promise you this night means a lot to him and how much he respects Derek, indicated by the fact that he's wearing a suit tonight to speak to all of you here. Number 15, Brad Davis.
Well, when we drafted Derek before training camp started, we'd all get together and do a little scrimmage, and after going up against them for about a week, I knew I was in for a long season practicing against Derek day in and day out. The one thing I respect about Derek is how intense he was and how competitive he was. It didn't matter if it was game 7 against the Lakers or 5-on-5 in practice. He always had that competitive fire. And I always liked it when he'd switch over and guard Rowe for a little while, because then I got a break, which was great. And I remember probably about halfway through the 85 season, Dick told our assistant coach, Bob Weiss, that he was going to make the change. He was going to put Derek into the starting lineup. So Bob came to my locker and said, you know, we're going to make a change. We think Derek's ready to be a starter. And I said, Bob, what took you so long? But I'd like to congratulate Harp. I've always admired the way he played, the way he conducted himself. One of the best teammates I've ever had. Thanks.
For 81 nights a year, you guys get to hear me tell stories and hear Derek and I interact with one another. So I'll get out of the way and just introduce the man that we're here to honor tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome the number 12 that's about to go up into the rafters, Derek Harper.
Journey, man. You know, let me start by first giving honor to God, the head of my life. I'm very humbled by this honor. I'm very grateful that Mark Cuban, along with the Mavericks organization, made it official that number 12 is going to hang in the rafters. I can truly say that I don't stand here thinking that one day my jersey was going to hang in the Raptors. That's not why we play the game. We play for the love, for the competition, for the camaraderie of teammates. So again, this is very humbling. One thing I can truly say is that my teammates in my day, Rolando Blackman, Brad Davis, Dennis Nutt, Eric Strickland, Michael Finley was a teammate for a little while, Jim Jackson, Jamal Mashburn, just all of the guys that I've shared a basketball floor and a basketball with. That's the reason why you play this game. There's no I in team. It might sound generic, but it's really true. And you're only as good at basketball than anything else. You're only as good as what's around you. And you guys supported me as a young player, as an older player, as I got older in the league. And I'm grateful, Ro, Brad, for everything that you guys gave me. You sacrificed for me, and I'm really grateful for that. This doesn't happen. This kind of stuff doesn't happen unless you have a support system throughout your career. And man, did I have a support system. My kids, they support me no matter what happens, no matter what we go through it together. I love you guys, Darius, Danielle, Tweet, Tudor, Munch. I love you guys the same way God loves us. I sincerely do. West Palm Beach in the house. I have some childhood friends, guys that I have known since I was 4 or 5 years old, could barely walk, and those guys have been there. They call it posse now, but we just call each other friends. And we've been friends since I can remember. These guys are honest with me. They tell me when I'm wrong. They don't uphold me in my mess. I went through a divorce. They were right there for me, and I'm grateful. Calvin Peoples, Paul Williams, Keith Arnett, Bernard Arnett, Elvin Richardson, Danny Moore, Tony Clay. You guys don't really know. You'll never know how much you have meant to me throughout my NBA career. You traveled a lot of miles to get here, and I'm glad that you all made it here, so I'm grateful to you guys. My mother, Wilma. I have a very praying mother. She prays for me all the time. So, Ma, thank you for your prayers, your guidance, but more importantly, teaching me to love my enemies. I greatly appreciate that. Hardest thing in the world you'll do is that. Coach Mata, what can I say? You were tough on me. You were really tough on me. But I always felt like it was for a reason. You kind of carved my career out. You told me all the time you had to get on me because Roe couldn't take it. Mark couldn't take it. So I was your whooping boy. And it actually set me on the right path, man, to be a hard-nosed basketball player. I think the one thing that I can truly say for myself, this isn't to boast, even though this night is about me. The reason why I can move on from basketball, why I was able to move on from the game, is because Dick Mata taught me how to leave it on the floor every single night. And that's important to me because that's important to me because I think that's what it's all about. It's about giving 100% for the fans, the reunion rowdies. My goodness gracious, where are you all at? Where are the rowdies, man? Where are the rowdies? Those were good old days at Reunion Arena. I'm looking for the MFFLs as well because you guys have supported me the same way. The original owners, Don and Linda Carter, couldn't be here, but they trusted in me. They drafted me in 83, 84, and I gave them all that I had. Doug Atkins is here. I saw Keith Grant up on the board up here. Keith, we know what we have. We know what we've been through. Kevin Sullivan, I mean, just so many different people. Steve Letson, give it up for Steve Letson because Steve Letson runs this place. He really does. He runs the American Airlines Center. If you guys don't know, now you know, Follow. I have to remember the three B's. I learned it from Satch Sanders. And Satch once told me to be brief, brother. So my time is running out. But before it does, again, I want to revisit Don and Linda Carter, Norm Sanju, Rick Sun, Bob Weiss, all those guys had a play in my career and all that I was able to accomplish. Now, I want to take this opportunity to thank Mark Cuban. Because of you, Mark, I have a championship ring. Because of Coach Carlisle, Don Nelson. Thank you, man. And I can't forget Dirk Nowitzki, who helped put a ring on my finger. I can't forget Sean Marion, who was also a part of the 2011 team. And my favorite player in the NBA is J.J. Barea. J.J. J.J., Sean, Dirk, they're the reasons why I do own a championship ring, along with the rest of the Mavericks staff in 2011. You guys have been really special to me, and I really appreciate you all. You know, on your journey, and I'm gonna let Dirk and Nose get back out here and finish this second half. On your journey, you have a lot of competition, and I competed against some of the best. Kurt Rambis is here as an assistant coach for the New York Knicks. Jeff Hornacek, Paul Pressey is here. Michael Williams, if I'm not mistaken, is here. All of you guys, I really enjoyed the competition. That's what it's all about. This is my night. I couldn't think of sharing this night with a better group of fans than the Rowdies, the MFFLs. God bless you all, and thank you very much.
Before we unveil the banner, we have gifts to present on behalf of Mark Cuban and the Dallas Mavericks. All right, first of all, you see right here to my right, we have the Dallas Mavericks making a $25,000 donation, Harp, to your favorite charity, the American Diabetes Association. Also, Bedgear would like to give you one of their sleep systems. Next up, you will receive an all-expenses-paid trip to a destination of your choosing with flights donated by American Airlines. And a statue to my right to commemorate this night. And so I guess that leaves just one order of business remaining. So if you would, Derek. And I think you're going to need some helpers. So Dana and Daria and Darius, come on. This isn't a one-person job. Your children will be here as well. Everyone grab a rope right over here. Going up next to number 15 of Brad Davis and number 22 of Rolando Blackman. Are we ready for the unveiling? Here we go. One, two, three. Thanks, everyone. As the banner goes back to the rafters now, we will get ready for the start of the second half shortly for the Mavs and the Knicks.